My name is Alex Griff, but people know me as Loksu. I'm from Chicago, Illinois, and now I live here in Seoul, South Korea as a lighting and media artist. I mainly focus on LED lighting installation work for different like bars, clubs, cafes, museums. And also I do like music performances where it's either recorded or live visual work. A lot of my work is primarily for these clubs and bars that open up. And so I create these systems that operate by computer and they automatically control the lighting systems for people. So when I lived in Chicago, I worked as a professional engineer at two different companies. Each one was like 3 years. But both of the companies that I worked at, it was a very just corporate life. Like you do all this hard work and research just to benefit some like higher CEO's paycheck. It just kind of made me feel miserable. Like I looked for new jobs and just always felt the same. So eventually I just realized like it just wasn't for me. So that just really pushed me to like do something new. And so from that point, that's when I decided to move here to Korea. Like my first project was this place called The Edge. And actually I like walked into this place and I didn't even know the owner, but then I was just having a conversation with him and he was telling me how he wanted to renovate his place, get new lighting. And right then I'm like, hey, I can do new lighting for you. And he was like, yeah, sure, let's do it. It was great. Like he trusted me to build something even though he didn't know who I was. And from there, it just kind of like cascaded on. Like he recommended me to people, those people recommend me to other people, and just keeps growing and growing and growing. Hydrovox now is a series, but the first one was, like conceptually was, we create a cylinder that she would sit inside, but we would have projections onto the cylinder. So that way it's this like 3D effect of like her inside this tank, but like these visuals are just like floating around her. That was like phase one, and like now we're just constantly making it grow. So now it's like, okay, we made the cylinder, how can we make it better? Okay, let's add LED bars around the whole room, but like, how do we control everything? Like, how do we manage all this? And it's really challenging too, because normal projection performances are just like a screen on the wall, but this one is like an actual structure. So every time like someone wants us to perform this Hydrovox at a place, we have to think about like the logistics. Like, how do we get this cylinder to this place? How are we gonna position the projector to like do what we want? Like how do we even set up in all these different environments? Like is the room really dark? Do we have the right electricity? Is the space big enough? Loksu Company is the people or like the group that makes these custom lighting systems for like permanent installations like clubs, cafes, bars. But then I also want to like pursue the artist direction as just Loksu. And so with Loksu, I'll do more custom and unique works where I do like more audiovisual content for like music videos and performances. And it's hard to say which one I prefer because I like both. Like one is kind of a job that I still have creativity in, whereas the art side is more freedom to do what I want. But of course, like I feel like I have to do both because to do art, you need the money. And to get the money, you need a job. So it kind of goes back and forth. Lighting is like something you look at, but also something that really sets the mood of a room. Seeing how people react to it and like seeing how good it makes them feel makes me want to keep making more. When I design stuff, it's more like, oh, this looks really cool. So then I hope when other people see it, they think the same thing. And that's just kind of what it is. Like, I don't really have a big story behind each kind of piece or anything like that. for me, I'm a perfectionist. So like everything has to be perfect all the time. Like even when it comes to preparing for projects, like I have to make sure I have like two of everything just so I'm always prepared if there's some kind of problem. I'm not saying that like you have to be double prepared like I do, but it's good to think about what can go wrong so that you're always ready for these kind of things. Because even after, what is it, like 4 or 5 years of this work now, like things that I never even expect still break. And it becomes such a headache, and you gotta just be patient about it and like accept that like this is part of the job. Because a lot of people think most of creative work or like designing stuff is just the fun part of designing. And no one thinks about like the maintenance and like the actual like dirty work that you have to do to make it done. Art and technology has this like weird like mixture together now. And so you have a lot of these things where like in trending art, technology is used a lot, but a lot of the technology is still pretty new. So you can't just like go online and find that kind of like information that you need. So there's still a lot of like research and development and engineering put into this kind of work that you have to make. That's really fun. I mean, like my whole life I've been like a hobbyist. And so now it's just like problem solving of how to make these like really creative structures that no one else has ever done. You can't just expect things to come to you. That was actually a problem for me a while. I was like, I would just sit around like waiting for people to like ask me for offers. But then I realized like you really have to like put yourself out there. Like you really have to go talk to people and show what you're doing and like really get people interested in your work and show that you're very passionate about what you're wanting to do.